Go on, get out of here.
Which is fantastic. He engages the public like no artist since Andy Warhol in the 1960s, and Murakami has his own hair. The current surge of interest in Japanese pop art really kicked off with a young artist named Takashi Murakami. Bored with the stagnant world of traditional Japanese art, he looked to contemporary culture for inspiration, and he found it in the otaku or uber-nerd passions of anime and manga. He has created subversive characters with names like Mr. Dot, a mad manic mouse, and Kai Kakai, two cute animal figures with an abundance of eyes. She was nothing but a vision trick. He dubbed this new style Super Flat, referring to the way it flattens tradition, modernity, and even other media into a new oneness. I met him at his studio outside Tokyo, where he showed me his latest rendition of Mr. Dot.
Wow, this is incredible.
Can I ask you, I don't know if this will seem how much would a pig painting this bench
be?
It's very kind of you to give it to me. What makes Murakami a true pop artist and a hugely successful one is his spin on Andy Warhol's idea of turning consumer products into art. Murakami turns his own art into consumer products. His mounting of merchandise includes Murakami toys, the Murakami sweets, badges, flowers, Monopoly, calendars, and public toys. When is something made? When is it just a toy? Or when is it a piece of art that can be used as a toy?
Japanese people are full of art, but the Japanese people at the same time.
It was too loud for me to hear her speak. And she had a broken arm, it was close. So close that the walls were wet.
He also collaborated with fashion icon Louis Vuitton on this bag, which sold for $5,000 and became one of the most copied handbags ever. He even went full circle and made an animated art film for Louis Vuitton that was perhaps the ultimate blending of art and commerce. By creating characters based on anime and manga and giving them a darker twist, Murakami is making powerful statements about post-war Japan. Some might say the Japanese invented cute, giving us the likes of Hello Kitty as a reaction against the brutal image the war had given the country. But Murakami doesn't look only to manga and anime for inspiration. Some of it comes from good old Mother Nature.
It's interesting because you can see these shapes in his work, just like the great Victorian artists were inspired by nature as well. Now that could be something in, you know, you put that through a computer and bung some colours on that, that's it. So you know, if you're a man and you check your prostate on a regular basis, you're going to be hearing that happen to you.
Murakami-san, thank you so much for your time today. It was a pleasure.
Thank you.
And continued success with your work. I think it is fabulous.
Thank you.
Arigato gozaimashita.
To find out how much of an effect Murakami's super flat movement has had on modern Japanese art, I went to this exhibition, held every year to help up-and-coming artists get their work seen.
I think he's made a huge achievement. Japanese pop art has a tremendous amount of power. Otaku is no longer a specifically Japanese thing.
The characters I created are images of healing. They are round and fat with bulging bellies. The first time I saw Murakami's work, I was very impressed with the way he combined his art with manga.
I really love manga since I was a kid, and when I started working as a graphic designer, we were also creating characters. It was then that I first got interested in characters as a method of expression.
This guy.
So, Murakami.
Murakami's super flat movement has inspired a wealth of young artists soon to be unleashed on an unsuspecting art world.
Drinks on my sense of truth. You are one. There's golden church, actually, I just saw.